Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series will show you some digital beauty retouching techniques. In the previous video, we looked at doing isolated spot removal. This video will focus on the majority of the face for skin smoothing and line removal treatment. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. So just as the marks on our face show off our character, so do the lines and skin quality. Skin smoothing is used for a variety of things. On a whole, it's used to make someone look younger and give them a more refreshed look. We'll apply some of this treatment to Matt. This time round, I'd like to just give a fresh and natural look. But it's up to you how overboard you want to go. Hover over the ConnectFX node bin and press G for the G-Mask node. Drag it out and connect the degrain clip into the node. I'll rename this node to Face Matte. We will use the masking tools in this instance to isolate large portions of the face where we will apply skin smoothing. Double-click on the node and click on the result view to activate the controls. Press F1 for the front viewer. Zoom into Matt's face and ensure you are on frame 1. Click Add and start drawing the mask around the left side of Matt's face. Just ensure that as you draw the mask, you don't include definite features such as eyes, eyebrows, nose, and mouth. This is more about the surrounding patches of skin. The recommended working practice is to do this in sections to make it easier to control. So this side of the face will be the first mask. Now before we do any tracking, you first need to set the softness. You can choose between using global softening with offset or vertices softening with the tracer. I will just adjust the offset slider so that the softness goes inward from the mask's outline. This will help with the blending later on. Now scrubbing the time bar from the beginning to the end, Matt goes from a frown to a smile. So the mask needs to follow the facial movement. Object tracking will not work because the mask needs to change shape over time to cover the area. Therefore, you need to track the vertex points of the mask. Hold Command and draw a box selection around all the vertices you'd like to track. The stabilizer button next to the transformation controls does object tracking. However, the stabilizer button next to the mask tools performs vertices tracking. Going into the stabilizer, you will see that each selected vertex was converted into a set of tracker boxes. Each tracker box will define the exact point of its vertex. So please bear that in mind when you start positioning the trackers. Now I want to globally affect all the trackers. So change the selection mode from selected to gang. Any settings changes you make will now affect all the trackers. Turn the fixed reference off. This ensures that the tracker will keep tracking even if the reference pattern changes over time. Click Analyze and the tracker should do the rest. You can work on individual trackers if needed, but once you're done, press Return to exit the stabilizer. Scrubbing the time bar, all the vertices should be animated according to their respective trackers. Now, here is something very important. If you need to offset a vertex, you can't simply pick it up and move it. This will result in messing up your track for the current frame you have adjusted. To adjust a vertex after animating it, change the Tools menu to Trans Keys. You can now move around the vertex without worrying that you're affecting the original animation. So this will help with any tweaking you might need. Just remember to set the tools back to Select mode once you're done. Now press F4 to see the mat that you have created with the mask tools. Now go ahead and repeat the same process on the other parts of the face to isolate them. I have already included a mask setup with the downloadable media. Just click Load under the GMask header. Change the loading option to Replace. Using Replace will wipe out what was originally created in the GMask node. Navigate to the downloaded files and load the face mask. So this was done using everything that we have gone through so far. Now let's smooth out the skin. Click the Effects Nodes button. Hover over the node bin and press B for Blur. Drag out the Blur node into the Connect Effects schematic. Connect the pixel spread output into the red front input of the Blur node. Rename the node to Clean Skin. So we have taken the result of the spot removal process with pixel spread and fed that into the Blur node. Double-click on the Blur node and increase the blur width and height. The whole picture is blurring, so we need the masks to isolate the areas of skin. Drag the output of the GMask node into the Blur Mat input of the Blur node. Under Blending, enable Use Mat. Now that looks much better. As I said, you can add as much blur as you like for the effect you want. Toggling the Bypass button shows you the before and after. You can see it makes quite a difference. The next step is to start returning some of the highlights and details that were lost because of the smoothing blur. In the next video, we add a detail pass to start rebuilding the skin's surface. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.